Three former Kampala Capital City Authority KCCA bosses battling 57 charges relating to Chitezi landfill slide on August 10th this year that left over 34 people dead and many injured have each been released on a cash bail of 5 million shillings. They include ex-executive director Dorothy Chisaka, ex-deputy executive director David Luimbazi and Dr. Daniel Okello, the former KCCA Director for Public Health. Releasing them on bail, Kasangati Chief Magistrate Beatrice Kainza said that she was satisfied with the four sureties each of them presented before court.
Together with submissions, the Kampala Municipal Authorities,
presumption of innocence, a right to be
I therefore exercise my discretion and release you on a cash bail of 5 million. Each of the four sureties have bonded a sum of 100 million, not cash. You are required to deposit your original passport in court.
The charges against the trio include manslaughter, causing death or harm by rash, or doing a negligent act. As former KCCA top bosses, the prosecution accuses them of being negligent, leading to the death of over 34 people following the Chitezi landfill slide. Regarding manslaughter, the prosecution alleges that between July 2020 and August 10th this year, at various places within Kampala City and Chitezi Landfill, Losanja Village, Chitezi Ward, Kasangati Town Council in Wakiso District, the trio, being persons bearing responsibilities for the safe and proper management of Chitezi Landfill by a series of unlawful acts or omissions, to wit, continuing to operate Chitezi Landfill without the relevant documents. And regarding manslaughter, the prosecution alleges that between July 2020 and August 10th this year, at various places within Kampala City and Chitezi Landfill, Losanja Village in Chitezi Ward, Kasangati Town Council in Wakiso District, the trio, being persons bearing responsibilities for the safe and proper management of Chitezi Landfill by a series of unlawful acts or omissions, to wit, continuing to operate Chitezi Landfill without the relevant permits and licenses. The National Unity Platform today graduated 103 of its members in the first cohort of the new School of Leadership at their head offices in Makere Kavule. In attendance was a special guest, also and party president General Mugisha Muntu, the new president Robert Chagulanyi, party secretary general David Louis Rubongoya, the leader of opposition in parliament Joel Senyonyi, Dr. Lina Zedriga, and new supporters. During the inaugural certificate awarding ceremony, General Muntu urged graduates to ensure discipline as they practice leadership.
This country is wealthy. You will build a country, it becomes wealthy, every individual benefits or accesses opportunity once you have a disciplined team in leadership.
We continue to challenge you to take your space in this world because it is equally yours. Young ladies, young leaders.
Chagulanyi and General Muntu later awarded certificates of completion to all those who completed the course. According to the National Unity Platform Leadership, the nine-month-long training is intended to nurture a new breed of leaders who respect their offices and the citizens they serve, while focusing on the party's values, principles, and goals. A volcano in eastern Indonesia erupted overnight, killing at least 10 people as it spewed fireballs and ash on surrounding villages, officials say today as they raised the alert to its highest level. Mount Leotobi Laki-Laki, a 1,703-meter, 5,587-feet twin volcano located on the popular tourist island of Flores erupted shortly before midnight, forcing authorities to evacuate several villages. Residents described the horror when the creature started shooting flaming rocks at their homes. Buildings near the volcano were covered by thick ash, while others had collapsed from falling volcanic debris, with the rubble still smoldering hours after the eruption. Some wooden homes caught fire and the ground was pockmarked with holes caused by flying molten rocks. The crater erupted just before midnight and then again at 1:27 a.m. and then at 2:48 a.m. the country's volcanology agency said. The agency hoisted the highest alert level because of an increase in volcanic activity, telling locals and tourists not to carry out activities within a 7-kilometer or 4.3-mile radius of the crater.